Hi, my name's Kent. I'm the Creative Specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to use the Outliner panel. In the default workspace, I see the Outliner on the right, and I'll rearrange to make it a little easier to see. The Outliner gives you a quick look at your document structure. For example, this file has 3 pages, and you can easily switch between them and get a quick look at their contents. The nested structure can be expanded and collapsed by clicking these triangle icons, and command-click or double-click expands the entire node, which makes it easier to quickly select a deeply nested item, like this text element. You can also select items directly that can't be selected on stage without hiding or locking a covering element, like this button. If I try that on stage, it's covered, so I need to hide or lock this top layer before I can select it. The Outliner selections are mirrored on stage, so anything selected in one is also highlighted in the other. For example, at the root of this page, I can select any one of the 7 children by clicking in the Outliner, the layer name, or on stage, and all 3 are synced. I can also command-click to select or deselect multiple elements of the same parent, and shift-click for arrange. When selecting an element, it's indicated with a light gray background, and you also navigate directly to its parent element, highlighted yellow. If I select this text, I see the container div is yellow. Now I can use the breadcrumbs to move up the DOM tree and see this reflected in the Outliner. Now the button component is highlighted, and now the page root is highlighted. Let's talk about interactions. You can reorder elements in your file by drag and drop in the Outliner, and you'll see a yellow line indicating the new stacking order. You can also change the DOM nesting, and you'll see an element highlighted and expanded when it's a valid drop target. Now my logo is inside the button, and Command-Z will undo this. You can also cut, copy, and paste elements using the usual keyboard shortcuts, Command plus C, V, or X. For example, I'll repeat the last change by selecting the logo, press Command-C on my keyboard, then navigate inside the button text container, and Command-V paste the copy. Then Command-X, or the delete key, removes the element. Another convenient feature is being able to right-click elements in the Outliner, just like the stage. I'll get that logo image and right-click to see the full context menu where I can create a mask, add an event, or any other regular action. Double-clicking in the Outliner is the same as double-clicking on stage. In this case, it opens the components dialog. By now, you've probably noticed all the different icons. Each element has an icon denoting its type, and these are just a few. An element's status is also shown, which can be locked, hidden, or a guide layer. Hover over any item and click these icons to toggle the state. Also, dynamic elements are indicated with a diamond icon, like this logo image, which has a dynamic binding. And this helps to quickly spot dynamic elements in a complex file. And last, we have some toolbar icons, which are used to filter the elements shown. For example, just images, which shows all the parents and ancestors, so you may have to expand to find the actual image. Or just components, text, or shapes. Or combine to see both text and shapes. You can also filter on a text string, for example, logo. In this case, the swipe gallery component is shown because I have a logo set as one of the 6 images it displays. I can also combine this with a type icon like shape. One final thing is that elements are listed in the same order as the timeline. I see the Outliner order matches the layer order. This is actually opposite of the DOM order seen in code view, but it can be changed. Edit, Preferences, Design View, Outliner, Sort Elements in DOM Order, and Save. Now when I select the top element, I see it's the bottom layer in the timeline. That does it for the Outliner panel in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.